Mama, Okay, I managed to go to Kapkatet Hospital. Nikapata kazi ilikuwa pole pole. Nimeona clinical officers alikuwa huko ndani. Lakini kidogo kidogo nikapata mtu yeye alikuwa analeta emergency na boda boda.
Que jarbuna ngene ana
unataka kusema sahihi? Haya, rudi nyuma kidogo. Rudi nyuma kidogo.
Yeah, you must look in. You must look in. The patio now. You must look at it. How is it?
You go from here to...
So are you live on here?
Yeah, we
are. And then the guy, you said, like, you be here to Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay, today, this morning around 11:45 a.m., we have had a fatal accident along Olenguron Silibet Bomet Road at Nyangores River, involving three vehicles, one canter. And two saloon vehicles. One of the saloon vehicles alongside were being driven towards Silibet from Olenguron direction with a saloon vehicle ahead of the counter. And when they approached Nyangores River, I think the counter lost control either due to a brake failure. And it rammed onto the back or the rear of a saloon vehicle, throwing it off the road onto the river, onto Nyangores River, where the vehicle was swept down about 500 meters downstream, where it was eventually stopped or held by a tree that was almost off the river. When we received a report of this accident, we responded, and we found this vehicle where it had been stopped, and on checking onto the vehicle, we found two people, one male and female. One we purport to be maybe a driver, and a female who was a passenger, all adults who had already passed on as a result of maybe the impact and the torrential water that was running through the vehicle that had been stopped. So immediately after we got this two about 20 meters away, downstream again from where we found this vehicle had been stopped, we also able to trace another body of a female whom we presume to have been one of the passenger who was also in the saloon vehicle. We have retrieved all the bodies and taken the three bodies to Tenwek Mission Hospital. But according to preliminary information that we got, is that in the vehicle we also had a minor who is a child. It could be a child because it appeared like the vehicle was carrying family members. So far, we have not been able to. The third vehicle was coming from the opposite direction, and I think when the driver saw what was happening or the accident, the way it had occurred, he got scary and he swerved the vehicle off the road until it landed on a ditch, but he was not injured. I want to say here that apart from three people who we have confirmed to have died as a result of this accident, we do not have anybody else who has been seriously injured, whom we are trying to trace wherever.
What are you telling the drivers?
For all drivers or anybody else or road users, we are in a rainy season. And there are challenges that are also arising out of a situation that we are driving on the road during the rainy season, because the roads are slippery and sometimes visibility is poor. So it is all upon the drivers really to keep to safety on the road by driving at stipulated speed limits, complying with all the traffic laws, including not overtaking at undesignated places. These undesignated places for drivers who are trained know where they are not supposed to overtake, where they are not supposed, because we have speed limits for all vehicles. For a counter like that, the speed limit for lorries, pickups, and even public service vehicle is 80 kilometers per hour. So it is the duty or the responsibility of drivers on the road to keep to speed limits. The reason is if you keep to your speed limits, you are able to control that vehicle just in case any eventuality occurs. You can be able to control and avoid a situation where an accident which would have minor injuries or less damages, occasioning everybody maybe to a fatality or serious injuries. So it is care for all of us, including motorcycle riders and even pedestrians, because road safety is a responsibility for everybody. Because when you keep yourself safe, then that it keeps everybody else who is using the road at any given time safe.
Naitwa Sami Kirui.
mi ni mmoja wafanyikazi wa afya. Kutoka Narok lakini naishi hapa Bomet. Imefanyika ya kwamba jambo mbaya imefanyika hapa Bomet leo baada ya kupoteza watu katika ajali ambayo imetokea namo masaa machache yaliyopita. Jambo hili imekuwa mbaya sana kwa sababu hakuna mtu ambaye alikuwa anatarajia kwamba kutakuwa na janga kama hili, lakini kwa ripoti ya watu ambao walikuwa hapa karibu tumepata ripoti ya kwamba kuna gari ambayo ilikuwa ikibeba familia na watu wachache pengine ambao walisaidiwa kuabiri wakielekea upande wa Silibwet, na kwa wale walioshuhudia kitendo hiki ni kwamba kuna gari ambayo ilikuja nyuma ya ile gari ambayo iliweza kupoteza breki na ikapoteza hiyo control. So gari hilo ambayo ilikuwa na mboga aina ya kabeji iliweza kugonga gari ile, na hapo ndipo gari lenyewe ambayo mnaona hapa mbele ambayo haijatolewa iliweza kuzama karibu mita 200 huko juu na ikasombwa na hii maji ya garika ambayo tumeweza kushuhudia katika sehemu ya Bomet na katika sehemu zingine katika nchi yetu. Tunasema pole kwa maafa ambayo imeweza kutokea katika siku ya leo, kwa sababu tumesikia kwamba kuna watu watatu ambao wameweza kufariki hapo ama ndani ya gari hilo, na majeruhi wengine waliweza kupelekwa katika hospitali ambayo iko karibu na Bomet. So tunasema pole na naomba tu ya kwamba watu wetu pia especially my drivers tuwe waangalifu, tuweze kuangalia kwamba tuzingatie sheria zote za barabara ili janga kama hili ziweze kuepukika. Otherwise tumesitika sana, we are so much sorrowed about such issues. Yeah, thank you, citizen.